start. Mr. Chairman, my honorable friend, the Food Minister, apologized for bringing in this measure at so late an hour, but he has given us no adequate reason for not having placed it before Parliament much earlier. When did the government become aware of the fact that food prices were rising? We have been aware of it for months. I think the finance minister too has expressed apprehensions more than once with regard to the rise in food prices, but the food minister himself has, I believe, consistently minimized the seriousness of the food situation. The price statistics have shown clearly for some time that prices were rising, and that in spite of the opening of fair price shops and the other measures that government took, there was no sign that the price would be stabilized. In spite of all that the government did, it was clear that prices were showing a tendency to rise. There is one other fact that I should like to bring to the notice of the House in this connection. Government, realizing that the position was becoming very difficult, has taken steps to secure food grains from other countries. So far as I know, it has entered into an agreement with Japan to get 2 million tons of rice from her during the 7th 5-year plan period. It has also taken steps to get, I think, about 3 million tons of food grains from America and perhaps from Australia too. The total quantity of food grains thus ordered is about 5.5 million tons. Under the agreement that they have entered into, they can even obtain, I think, about 80 or 90,000 tons more, or even a little more, perhaps about 1 million tons more. They therefore knew that the present situation would soon become more difficult in the near future. That is why they took steps to enter into an agreement with other countries to obtain the food supplies badly needed by the country. Yet the food minister comes to us at the 11th hour and wants the bill to be discussed as an emergency measure. Is this, sir, fair to the House? There may be holding and it may have to be dealt with, but I object very strongly to the procedure that the government has adopted. This is not the first time, sir, that the government of India have acted in this manner. Now, sir, the food minister says that food grains are being hoarded. Is this a complete exposition of the rise in food prices? We all know that the food position in Bangladesh is very unsatisfactory. It is also known from newspaper reports that rice is being smuggled into Bangladesh. This is not a new phenomena, but something that has come to light during the last 4 or 5 or 6 days. This too has been known to government for a pretty long time. It was also known to them that in spite of what they were doing, smuggling was increasing. Yet they slept over the whole affair and came before Parliament when it was going to adjourn. There may be some holding in the country, but I should like to ask the Food Minister to tell us whether this bill would provide the remedy that is needed. This bill cannot prevent anybody from smuggling rice into Bangladesh. It was said once that the rise in price of food grains was the result of hoarding. When prices are rising, people who hope to gain by the rise in prices may resort to more than one unsocial practice in order to secure some gain for themselves. But to think that these illegal practices are the only cause for the rise in prices is to make a serious mistake. Government should realize that their own policy is partly responsible for the rise in prices. They are indulging in deficit financing every year, and then they come to us and talk about hoarders and the people who indulge in unsocial practices and so on. The government, from the Prime Minister downwards, have got into the habit of saying that the economic position of the country must be developed as rapidly as possible and that we must be prepared to make sacrifices at present for the benefit of future generations. Then we must recognize our own responsibility for what is happening at the present time, but there was no sign of that in the speech of the food minister. The purpose of his speech was that food prices were rising because of the existence of hoarders in the country. I hope, sir, nobody will be taken in by this statement. The parliament has been discussing the food situation for many years, and there are many members of this parliament whose memories are not so short as the food minister thinks. We know almost quite as much about the food situation as he himself does. Now, sir, granting that something has to be done to check the rise in prices, even temporarily, what has the government done about food grains? Mr. Chairman, the finance minister referred in March last to the difficulty of obtaining the foreign exchange required for the second five-year plan. He referred to it again in May last, but he said that whatever the difficulties might be, he believed that sufficient resources would be available for the hard core of the plan. In other words, he thought that certain projects which were included in the phrase hard core of the plan could be carried through, while certain other schemes or projects might have to be left out. His last statement on this subject was made a few days ago in another place. The word that is favored now by the government with regard to the plan is rephasing. The Planning Commission and the government are now engaged in rephasing the plan. The finance minister, while referring to this, said that whatever the people spoke of the refacing of the plan or of the allocation or reallocation of priorities, it meant that a little pruning was implicit in the re-examination of the plan. Now, sir, we should like to know that exactly this refacing means. The Planning Commission may not have finished its examination of the question, but I think we can be usefully told on what principles the government are proceeding and what is the extent to which a reduction is likely to be made in the cost of the plan. I read a few days ago, sir, in a daily that it was being considered whether the fertilizer projects might be cut out of the plan. Now the finance minister has told us that what constitutes the hard core of the plan is the production of steel mining, transport and power. Now is the production of food essential for carrying out of the plan or not? Is it included in the hard core of the plan, or has it been given a lower priority than steel and other things? It is very important for us to have this information because we can form our judgments with regard to the rephasing of the plan in connection with the measures that are to be placed before this house very soon, only when we know what the ideas of government on this subject are. It may not be possible for the Honorable Finance Minister to state what the exact extent of the reduction in expenditure will be. At one time, sir, we were told that all the schemes in the plan stood or failed together. If greater industrialization was needed, it was necessary that more food should be produced, that education should be spread so that people who can understand the latest technological processes might be available, and so on. It is this that makes it necessary for us to ask how the ideas of the government on this subject have changed and what, broadly speaking, they propose to do now in view of the shortage of foreign exchange and the danger of having recourse to deficit financing to a large extent. Sir, I referred a minute ago to the importance of increasing food production. Now, several measures have been taken by Parliament and by government to make more food available to the people. The Essential Commodities Act was amended last year in order to give government the power to requisition stocks believed to be hoarded by grain dealers. Then it was announced that India was being divided into a number of zones because it was believed that restrictions on the free movement of food grains would bring down their prices and consequently lessen the temptation to hoard. Then, sir, in addition to this, the Reserve Bank asked the scheduled banks to reduce the advances made by them for the purchase of food grains because it was believed that the bank advances were being used in order to buy more and more food grains and hoard them. As a result of these measures, the food minister could say 3 or 4 weeks ago that the rise in food prices had already been checked. Let us see first how far the production of food has increased and to what extent prices have fallen. I shall take first the production of food. The Planning Commission, in its review of the work in the first year of the second plan, said that according to the food production program, an addition in food production potential of about 2.5 million tons was expected to be realized in 1956-57. And that increase in production is estimated to be of the order of 1.4 million tons. The statement made by the Planning Commission depended on the forecast made at the end of April by the Food and Agriculture Ministry. But a week later, the Food Ministry claimed that the production of food was not 66 million tons, but a little over 68 million tons. There was a difference of about 2 million tons in the two estimates made at an interval of a fortnight. Full stop over.